Pivot tables allow you to analyze and report on vast quantities of information quickly and easily. In this segment, you'll learn how to activate the feature, set up your database to be used in a pivot table report, and how to manipulate the pivot table to meet your needs. In this example, we have a database with a number of columns. We've got date, supplier's number, a currency, document numbers, the amount, balances, supplier name, etc. What we'd like to do is to be able to summarize and report on this information quickly and easily. Pivot tables are the ideal tool to handle this type of situation. But before we get into the pivot table, it is important to know what needs to be done with the database to make sure that it is acceptable to the pivot table reports. First and foremost, all columns must have a heading and they must be unique. So you'll see here this column that is blank has been labeled blank, and there are no headings that are duplicates. This just makes it easier for Excel to understand what information is being inserted into the pivot table. Furthermore, there should be no subtotals. So you'll see right at the bottom here, we have a total. We must be very careful to exclude it from the pivot table, and all subtotals have been removed. To activate the pivot table, click anywhere in the list of data and go to Data, Pivot Table and Pivot Chart Report and click on it. And what you'll see is you'll be asked a couple of questions. So firstly, you'll generally be working in a list in Microsoft Excel and you want to work on pivot tables for now. So you'd say next. The next aspect is it highlights what it thinks the list is. And I highly recommend you have a good look at it to make sure that you agree. So in this case, you can see the dotted lines have included that. They go to the end. When we come down here, you'll see that they've included subtotals which we do not want in there. So we just need to put it to row 529. So we'll go to 529. And we say next. At this stage, you now have the option of where you want the report to go. So it can be in a new worksheet, or you can click on existing worksheet and put it in one of the cells. But before you do any of this, I recommend you click on the layout button to set up the layout of your first pivot report. So if we click on that now, this may look confusing, but as you work more and more with pivot tables, you'll find this very easy to understand. What Excel is asking for is what the report must look like. In any report, you can have a rows of information where you categorize information, you can have columns, and you can even have pages, and then you have the data itself. And what I recommend is the first one you do, just make it as simple as possible. So in this case, we've got this item called supplier number, and what I want is to list in the row by supplier number. And we've got an amount, so all I want to do is put it in the data section. And you'll see it comes up with sum of amount. And that for now is good enough. And we can click OK. We are now in a position to generate our first pivot table report. We've maintained that we need it in a new worksheet. And if we click Finish, a report like this will be generated. Just to explain this report, what it tells you up here is that the data in the total field is the sum of the amount column. Down the column, it's using the supplier number column, and as you can see, there's supplier numbers, and this will be the sum of all amounts referring to that supplier number. Whenever you click in this area, this pivot table field list will appear, which enables you to play around with the report. When you see these little arrows, if you click on them, it'll show you all the components of that column. And it gives you capability to, let's say, you decide you don't actually want to see supplier number 1201. When you click OK, it'll redo the report without that number. And you can go back and switch them all on. We can now move on to the real power of pivot table reports. As you can see, our report is set up with the supplier number and the sum of the amount. But let's say, looking at these field lists, that we actually want to include the month that these amounts occur. What we can do is you grab the item, click on it, drag it across. Now that indicates you'll put it into the data field. You don't want to do that. Perhaps you want to put it here in the column field. And when you let go, what it does is quickly splits the column so that now you've got a supplier number, you've then got the months, and then the totals making up each month. If you're unhappy with that and you'd rather have the month being the primary form of categorization on the row, just grab it and you move it to the other side. And now what you'll have is all the months and all the supplier numbers that make up that month. And perhaps if you want to maybe rather have the end of months coming along the columns, if you drag it there, now what you've got is a supplier number split up by the month ends with the amounts in it, all coming to a grand total. The number of reports you can generate is almost limitless. So for example, we've got our supplier number, we now have the months across the columns. Let's say we take this description and pull it across by the supplier number, and we let go. And now suddenly you've got a more detailed report. Another useful feature of pivot tables is the ability to drill down into the summarized information. So if we remove this item, you'll see that here in March, there's an amount of 2,978 for supplier number 1201. If you double click on that cell, what it generates is a new sheet with the component items that make up that amount. So you can actually check back to see what has made up that total. Getting back to the pivot table report, you also have a number of other options. So for example, you can double click on these headings and a little box will pop up. And as you can see, at the moment, it's saying you must summarize by sum and it's called sum of amount. But let's say you don't want it to be summed, you actually want to count how many items are for each supplier per month. Then you click on count, and you say okay, and what will be listed is the actual count of how many items it found in each area. And again, if you double click, it'll list those items. Although this might look complex for now, you'll find that as you work with them, you get to understand what is happening here a lot better. So for example, let's remove this end of month and go back to the sum situation. And that is a report that is useful anyway. You can now feel free to go maybe include the supplier name. And this provides a report and its subtotals per supplier number. If you right click while you're in a pivot table, a number of options will pop up. You'll see that here you've got an option to go back to the wizard that helped you set up the pivot table. And you can also refresh the data. So if changes have been made to the underlying data, you need to refresh it so that the pivot table updates. But if we go back to the wizard, we'll see that you're back at this stage. If you click the back button, you can go. So let's say you've added more data, you just need to make sure that it still covers the list. Or perhaps if you prefer to work in the layout view, you can click there and start to work on the layout of your reports. And again, although it looks complex, all you have to think about is what data you're trying to summarize. Are you summing, counting, averaging? And how are you going to categorize it? And once you've understood that, you'll be a long way down understanding how pivot tables report.